Jesus Christ carried the what? Carried the cross. 5 years ago, God sent me and my wife to a city we never know. It is called Seattle. You know, we were looking for, you know, looking for the name of the city on the what is it called? On the internet. And I said, God, and after 1 year, we didn't send anybody to invite us. We called all the pastors there, please say, God, send us to your city. Help us to come. Nobody wanted to invite us. And then I felt sick. And then I didn't know why I felt sick. Eventually, I went to go. I just dropped my wife at work and I said, let me check my blood pressure because I've used all analgesia from paracetamol to ibuprofen. Do you understand? Are you following my story? Then, when my blood pressure was checked at AIE, it was 180, over 150. I've never reached that place in my life. And then, they referred me to my doctor the following day. And then, according to the report, they took my blood, they checked everything, and I was losing one kidney. Renal failure. Then I went to God, what have I done? God said, I sent you an errand, you are still here. And then I said, yeah, I will go. The Lord, are you going? I told him where we are going. Then eventually I found myself in that place. By the time I returned, within 1 year, renal failure disappeared. Because the Bible says the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but they are mighty through the world. To the pulling down of struggle. But look at verse 6 of that particular scripture. He said, having in readiness to avenge every disobedience. When what? When your obedience is fulfilled. Did God say something there?
Yes, Lord.
So, when I'm trying to understand, I want us to understand our daddy, our eternal father, our everlasting father, so that we can pray effectively. And then, we can embrace what that he has done for us. So let me just look at it, the definition here. It says, he was wounded for our transgression, bruised for our iniquity, chastised for our peace, was upon him, and with his stripes we were healed. In other words, the things that make you sorrowful, sir, all the time, Jesus Christ took the price. So that's why God, I said to him, God, own Jesus, not you. He owned Jesus to do you good. Do you get that? Yes, you know. So, if you look at the scripture very well, we must have to begin to apply all that Jesus Christ has done for us so that we can reach out to the blessing. Let's look at John chapter 10, verse 10. In John 10, 10, Jesus Christ was speaking. He said, I know my sheep. Is that not so? And I'm God of mine. He said, they hear my voice, but the voice of the stranger they will not follow. Do you know that was not the one that excited me most? Let's go to 27. John 10, 27 and 28. Hallelujah. Are you getting something?
Yes, sir.
Is God preparing our heart?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. I will see now. John 10, let's look at it in 27, 28. What are we saying in 27, 28?
I know my sheep.
He said, I know my sheep. Oh, I thought you are helping me to read. He said, I know my sheep. Is that not so?
Yes.
They hear my voice. And I know them. And they follow me. Look at verse 28. Everybody look at verse 28.
I give
unto them eternal life. And then look at what followed that. And they shall never what? Oh, come on. And then, not only that, look at what further that from. People are not saying that what they know. You don't mean it.
Amen.
No, you don't mean it. No. Don't stop. You don't mean it. You are just reading that scene. Teenagers were reading. If you know this, if you know how this thing is to me, if you know what this thing is to me, these are the things that make people bubble. Let's go back again. 27, 28. Let's see what we mean it now. Okay, what he says? Look at 11 from 27. He said what?
My sheep
hear my voice. And I know them. And then they follow me. Look at verse 28. He said, and I give them eternal life. And they shall never. They shall never. They shall never. Oh, God. Never said anyone. Never said anyone. Never Psalm 92. I want to. Are we following each other?
Yes.
Look at Psalm 92. Oh, I love the Psalm today. Oh, you know, sometimes, brethren, sometimes when trouble comes and I've prayed and I seem not to be getting result, I just say, God, it is you. I just go and sleep. I go and sleep. Whether I see a vision, a snake is running around, or can it come to me? I go to sleep. Answer. So that's when I will come and I say, hey, come down. I go to sleep. You know why? Say, be still and know that I am God. Third word I want you to understand in this word. He said, number one, be still. It's in your stillness of heart that you come down. You can have the knowledge of who you know you serve. If you are confused, if you are running around the way the enemy wants to run around, you can never have a restful mind. Let me tell you one different thing before we go to 92. The different thing that distinguished the woman with the issue of blood and the crowd was that woman said, if only I can touch the end of his garment, if I demonstrate to you what happened, you will know that the trouble is right there in your heart. If you can take care of the trouble in your heart, it is finished. Your trust in God remains absolute. How do I mean? There are people that surrounded Jesus. Jesus was being shot by the crowd. Is that not so? And then somebody was coming from the end. You are also picture the crowd in your heart. Please just listen to me. So not everybody is listening. I want you to listen. I want you to picture the crowd in your heart. Look at how mighty. Look at how big they are. And then one person, just one woman who has been sick 20 years. Touch in his hand, if one of them touch the hem of his garment, how did she come to recognize that it was the hem of the garment of Jesus that he touched? Did you get something? Did you hear that? Did they come open my eyes to that and say it is true? Because the Lord put on Reka, Babariga, long something, and most of them white. How did she, this woman come to recognize that? That was the garment that she told. Oh God, it was the step of my heart. Yes, I received it. I got it right. And from that day, the Bible said the fountain of her blood ceased. If only you can prepare your mind today to say everything that pursues to this place cease. It is cease. Because Jesus has paid the price. We are talking of Jesus here. We are not talking of a man. Look at Psalm 92. Let's look at Psalm 92. It's one of the psalms that I discover in praising God. Psalm 92, I love this psalm. Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Glory to God. Psalm 92. Is somebody there with me? He said, it is a good thing to give thanks unto God. Oh, sing praises unto his name forever. Now, let's go to verse 6. He said, a prudent man does not know, that that was a fool, understand this. Who is a foolish man?
The one that said that is not God.
And who is a prudent person? Now, why am I saying this? Look at it. Look at what follow. Look at what follow. Please, watch. When I say my father sent it to you, you better believe me. Next time, you will jump up. If you have a Bible, you go for a Bible. Look at what followed. He said, when the wicked spring as what?
Grass.
Have you ever seen grass is springing up? In a very fast way. So he said, when the wicked spring as the grass, what are they aiming at? What is God aiming at? Eh? In other words, even when the wicked chooses not to spring, God himself will go and wake them up.
Wake up.
I need you. He will go from house to house of the witches and the witchcraft.
Wake up.
I need you. Wake up. I need you. Wake up. It's time for the promotion of my son. Wake up.
I need you.
Wake up. So Bible says, when they split up as grass, woo, what's about to happen? It is that God might destroy them. He said, but my heart you will exalt like the heart of a unicorn. In other words, my promotion has come. It is time for my promotion. That's why the wicked has to spring up. If the wicked were not allowed to spring up, there will be no destruction, there will be no promotion. Do you understand God now? Has God sent it to you or not?
Yes.
Oh, God. Please don't look at time. Okay. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Exodus 14, when the people left Egypt, they got stuck. They are not able to reach one quarter of the road. They got stuck. There was a Red Sea in front of them, and there was war coming behind. And look at what God said. Look, the problem of the people of Israel was caused by God, not the devil. He said three things. He said, I will not allow him to let them go because I will harden his heart. He said, I, God, I will harden Pharaoh's heart so that I will glorify myself. And from that till its destruction, the heavens and the earth, they put it in record. There is no book, there is no tongue, there is no nation in the world that does not know of the battle of the Red Sea.
Hallelujah.
Allow God to glorify himself.
Amen.
He said to them, the sea shows that only two places, Psalm 46 verse 10, and in that Exodus, he said, be still and know that I am God. When God said, I want to prove myself in your life, you better be shaking yourself. Because the only thing that can rescue God is praising God, praising God. When God said, son, it's time for you, I just want to glorify myself in your life. Hey! Or he said, daughter, I want to glorify. Who doesn't want promotion? But promotion doesn't come by GP. You better just be praising God. Because you don't know what's going to happen around you. Some trees will fall, some grasses will disappear. Yeah. So number some things, some human people will just be falling in. You begin to wonder. You won't even tell you, but you will know that this is the finger of God. Be still and know that I am God. You know why? The Bible says that the eye of the Lord runs to and fro. Runs to and fro. The face of the earth to deliver them whose hearts trust in him. Is that not so? That the devil walks. What is the difference between running and walking? The devil walks. When he's in America, it will take him thousands of years to walk to Britain. Months to walk to Britain. Meanwhile, the eye of the Lord have gone to and fro, 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 to deliver them, not his heart, trust in him. Hallelujah. Psalm 31, Isaiah 35 said, he is the Lord that sits upon the circle of the earth, who ruling in the affairs of men. You know why sometimes we don't trust God? I will tell you another thing is why we don't trust him. Nobody likes pain. Nobody likes pain. No, but don't forget the day your mother delivers you. You didn't just come out free of charge. That was pain.
Yes, sir.
There was pain. Any of you see me on the street, you think, this brother, many of us know I'm from Africa. Not everybody knows I'm from Africa. I'm an African man. Very few of you. But I became a white man, not by God, but by the devil. And I tell you, it was a painful day. I was born out black as this young man. Didn't be flair. But look at me today. If I had seen me 3 years ago, I was much whiter than this today. 6 times I've seen the spirit of death. The first 3 times I was afraid. About the fourth time I said, come, I'm ready. Can you imagine when death begins to run away from you? And I'm not joking. I'm not saying to make you laugh, but I'm saying the truth. By the time he comes the sixth time, and he could not reach at me, just I can describe how he looks like. 6 times. And if after 6 times I've not seen him, when it becomes so difficult for the devil to kill you, what do you think will be happening? Are you getting some message from the air? Are you getting something? Because I know by what is happening to your ministry today in this church, intercessors are coming up. That's what God told me. It's allowing some things to happen so that you can take care of your future. Intercessors are coming up. People are going to be put in places. Are you listening to me? Now you begin to function as good people of God in this place. God wants to identify those who are for him here. When Moses stayed for long in the mountain, the people became divided. When that man came and said, who is on the left side? Brethren, we either know him and believe him, or we don't know him at all. Because the danger in it is this. I'll tell you the danger in it. If you are a learner, if you are a learner, a driver with a learner, you don't put learner on your car. You'll be driving in accordance to the same law that everybody else drives. That is what the police will expect you to do. That is what the other motorists will expect from you. Why? But if there's an accident caused by you, because you are an unknown learner, you'll be held responsible. Whether that person is guilty or not. So, if you want to be a Christian, be a Christian. Because it's only a Christian that the devil runs after. He doesn't care about those already in his net. Yes, his worry is you and I. Are you getting the point? So if you want to be a learner, put learner on your car. Let us know you are a learning driver. The driver still learning how to drive. Everybody will know how to run from you. But when you don't put that thing there and you're a learning driver, everybody expects you to drive. But when you are driving 20 miles per hour on a 60 mile per hour, they will be put on this in the gutter. You can't see the danger there. So it is because it has got the responsibility of God to take care of us because Jesus Christ paid the price. He paid the price. Everything the Father needed, he paid the price. And that's why he said in John 14, 13 and 14, he said, look, whatsoever thing you ask the Father in my name, open check. Oh, and you love it. Whatsoever, whether negative or positive, you can demand the death of a person, the Father will do it in the name of your son, Jesus. Amen. You can demand a life from God in the name of Jesus. The Father has no choice but to do it. You get to that point. Whatsoever you want to any amount that you want, just write it on this check. Go to Barclays Bank, it shall be given to you. Yes. Amen. You've heard something like that before. just to take time to pray. We'll pray. We'll spend the rest of the time to pray. And I want to believe the things you have said. Because I thought I was coming to preach between 2 and 5 p.m. That's what I prepared for. So I didn't open what I prepared. And I know the Holy Ghost has spoken.
Amen.
Shall we rest on our feet? I want you to write out the thing that brings sorrow to your heart. If you cannot write them out,
write them on the tip of your heart.
Are you with me? You know why I'm asking to write it out? I liked one principle from my first pastor, 1986 or 1987. He said, anytime trouble comes to him, the first thing he does is to sit down and multiply it by zero. Have you heard that before? Anytime, no matter how many trouble, anytime this trouble comes, the first thing he does is to sit down and multiply it by zero. How many of us know anything multiplied by zero is what is the result?
Zero.
Even when his wife had a child that has a lot of handicap, many organs were missing in his body, he still sat down and multiplied everything zero. But there was a member of our church then. Anytime there was any problem in his house, he would come to the pastor's house. He would knock and knock. The pastor would open the door. Anytime the devil knock at his door, he was coming to knock at the pastor's door. Until one day, he told us himself, the pastor slept off. So he knocked and knocked and knocked. The devil was at home. So he ran to the pastor. He knocked and knocked and knocked. The pastor did not open the door. And he had to be 3 gates. So the pastor didn't hear. And then those are not the days of the phone, the cell phone. So there was no response. So what happened? The man went back home, struck. Do you understand what I'm saying? Sometimes God makes this thing to make us to be strong.
Amen.
The man you are looking at today cannot give you the testimony unless I've got for it. And that's just one out of many. Are you with me? I'm going to pray. I want you to open your Bible. To Isaiah 64. Isaiah 64. Isaiah 64. How many of us are ready to pray here? No, you see, I'm not watching you. How many of us whose heart is prepared to pray? Okay, let's start. I'll start from Isaiah 64. Let's look at Isaiah 64. We are reading verses 1 and 2. Look at the scriptures. It is talking about a man who is in serious pain. look at this man. This man was in serious pain. He has fought. He said, look, I've had enough. Let me talk to the real warrior. I'm telling you why I know he was in a serious pain. Now, look at what comes after heavens. Does that show somebody who is at peace? Am I saying the question? Look at what he said. He said, so if you are going to read it, how do you read it, my sister? How do you read that Isaiah, the first two lines?
Yeah. Oh, that you would rain the heaven.
So you didn't get it. How do you read it?
Oh.
You didn't get it. Nobody said to me, I know, because I know the church. It's not the church. Let me give you an example. Listen to me. If I know I can hear twice, and I think I've beaten you once. Okay, now did you feel anything? You didn't talk because they don't hear you. Now, if I use this thing to hit you on the forehead, how will you explain? You just say this. You just say, thank you, Pastor. Is that what you're going to say? That man was in pain. I want you to read it. He said, oh, that you will rend the heavens, that you will come down, that the mountains might shake at your presence. And then continue. He said, continue on. Because as fire burns peacefully, and as fire causes water to move out, to burn. And they will follow. That they make your name known to be have mercy, that the nations may tremble at your presence.
Thank you. Rasta,
If you look at 2 Chronicles chapter 20,
they won't know what the brother of the time.
All who were lost in the days of Jehoshaphat. And Jehoshaphat was so smart. He went to God at the altar. Remember the day this altar was dedicated to you? Never promise us defeat. He said, you are with us always. Therefore, look at them. They have surrounded us. There's no hope. But you have a hope. But you are our hope. You are the one that we trust in. And God said, and God said, stand still. And God said, stand still. And God said, I will be glorified. And God said, the battle is mine.
Thank you.
what he says. He said, they, in this church, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of his testimony.
Lord,
are you with me? In Romans chapter 8, if I get it right, verse 32, he said, if God will spare not his only son, but deliver him for us all, how then will he hold back from us whatever that we ask of him? In Romans chapter 4, verse 25, if I can remember, I said, Jesus was delivered for our offenses, and then he was risen for justification. We are going to hold our hands together and pray this morning. Remember the day the enemy thought they have captured Saul, Paul of Silence. How many of us remember Paul of Silence? Or Paul of Tarsus? They thought they captured that man. He was beaten. And the Bible says, as though he were what? He was dead. But what happened when the brethren surrendered the corpse of Paul? The Bible says, life came back to this man. And he rose up again. And he lives. And he continues. Oh, goodness me. Yes. I don't want any pain. I don't want any pain. We're going to pray. We're going to demand. Lord, today, we demand life to anything that is dead in this ministry. We demand life in accordance to those scriptures. Are you with me? Say after me, Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Today.
Today,
in the spirit of unity,
in the spirit of
and oneness, because the Bible says, these people are one, nothing shall be withheld from them. We are here today,
we are here today,
in the power of the unity,
in the power of the,
in the name of the Lord Jesus.
We are here today,
in the power of the blood of Jesus that he has shed and given for us. We are here today, in the power of Jesus. We make a demand. Everything that is dead in this church, let life begin to spread. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray. Everything that has spread dead, let life take over. Let life take over. Let life take over. Let the effect of the Lord. You can just a prayer once at a time. I hope your mind is forgiven. God bless you. Two more prayer points. Let's open our Bible to Ephesians chapter 6. This one has to deal with you now. Ephesians chapter 6. And then with one finger, you're going to open to the book of Psalm 18. Are we on Ephesians chapter 6? Okay, I'm going to read from I'm going to read from verse 13. When I finish leading people on warfare prayers, what I normally do, I want you to be covered. Do you understand? Because I know what has happened in the realm of the spirit.
Amen.
You don't have to know it with your eye. Something has been dislodged. Something has been uprooted. Something has been visited by the six elements of creation. Are you with me? And I want your security in the blood of Jesus. And that's why if you look at Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 11, you are going to open your Bible right now to be saying to yourself, are you with me? From verse 11 down to verse 17. He said, put on therefore the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Now, look at the way Paul described all those people and the end of wickedness in high places. The enemy doesn't like you. Now, if you can understand what I'm teaching you at this hour, your battles in life will be less. But if you choose not to understand it, you'll be fighting day and night. Are you with me? You will pray for people that the enemy will come back and ask you questions. Do you understand what I'm saying? So that's why I always like to put people through. Now, in that said, wherefore take unto yourself what? The whole armor of God, that he may be able to stand the evil day, and have it done all to stand. So in other words, without the armor of God, you will not be able to stand the evil. So you must put on what? The armor. Amen?
Amen.
Now say now, stand therefore, having your loins girded with the truth, having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod up with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith he shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And then, most importantly, take the element of salvation and the sword of the spirit. Amen?
Amen.
Now, let's put your hand there and then we'll go to Psalm 18. You know, Psalm 18 is my multivitamin. Hello?
Hi.
Yes, Psalm 18 is my multivitamin. When I'm so low, because sometimes this man is not as powerful as you think he is. It's the power of Jesus. And when I'm low, I know it's like when you have infection, then they want to give you what is it called? Antibiotics. I go for multivitamin. Psalm 18. Now don't forget your one finger is in Ephesians chapter 6. So let's put Psalm 18 together. It's a terrible psalm. Psalm 18, are we there?
Yes.
Oh, you are better than me today. No, I told you I'm not as specific as I am. Hallelujah. We are going to read from verse 32. Now, look at it today. If I were in your shoe, you are not going to look at this one. Your Bible. That's what we are going to look at. Because you are going, it's going to, you know, as you are beholding what you are reading. This one is just, it can be as fast as you want to be. And I know what I'm talking about. Now, look at what it says from verse 32. Are we ready now?
Yeah.
He said, it is God that guide me with strength and make my way perfect. He made my feet like what? High feet. And then set me upon high places. He teach my hands to walk so that the bone of steel is broken by my hand. Thou hast also given me the shield of the salvation and the right hand has holding me up. And your gentleness has made me great. You have enlarged my step under me that my feet did not slip. I have pursued my enemies and overtaken them. Neither did I turn again till they were consumed. I have wounded them. They were not able to rise. They are falling under my feet. Because thou hast gathered me with strength unto the battle. Thou hast subdued under me those that rose up against me. Thou hast also given me the neck of my enemies, that I might destroy them that hate me. They cry, but nobody will to save them, even unto the Lord, but they are silent not because of me. Then the devil picks them small. As the dust before the wind, I cast them out as the dust in the street. Thou art determined from the strivings of the people, that thou hast made me the head of the heathen. The people whom I have not known shall serve me. Does it have any meaning? Now we put on the armor of God and then we come here together. Individually, you are going to lead your own. The moment you get to verse 46, just begin to pray for yourself. So say after me, Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Like I said, don't forget to, like I said, when you finish putting on the armor of God, you come to verse, you know, to Psalm 18, okay? Then we'll read that together. Are you with me? Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Today
I put on
the armor of God. I cover my head with the helmet of salvation against every wickedness of the devil. In the name of Jesus, I put on the sword of the Spirit and I cut it in bitter pieces. Everything that is not of God that have come my way, in the name of Jesus, I put on the first place of righteousness by the righteousness of your Son Jesus Christ. I put on the belt of truth because your word is truth. I put on the shield of faith to receive every friendly death of the devil, in the name of Jesus. And I put on myself right now the shoes of the gospel of the kingdom, and I stand like a mighty man of war in the hand of the Lord Almighty, in Jesus' name. Now let's go to Psalm 18.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Have you heard Psalm 18 now? Okay, one, two, go. It is God that guide me with strength and make my way perfect. He made my feet like nice feet and set me upon my high places. He did my hands to war so that the bone of steel is broken by my hand. Thou hast also given me the shield of your salvation, and your right hand has broken me up, and thy gentleness has made me great. Thou hast enlarged my stand under me that my feet did not slip. I have pursued my enemies and overtaken them. Let them die to the way till they were consumed. I have wounded them that they were not able to rise. They are falling under my feet. Thou hast gathered me with strength unto the battle. Thou hast subdued under me those that rose up against me. Thou hast also given me the necks of my enemies, that I might destroy them that hate me. They cried, but I was not to save them, even unto the Lord, but the answer not from. Then the night beat them strong as the dust before the wind, and it cut them out as the dark in the street. Thou hast delivered me from the spirits of the people. Thou hast made me the head of the heathen. The people that have not known shall serve me. As soon as they hear my name, they shall obey me. The strongest shall submit themselves unto me henceforth. The strongest shall fade away and be afraid out of their most places. The Lord liveth. Blessed be my Lord.
I don't want to be a soul. He prayed.
Amen.
We declare your lordship here. We declare that name that your father has given unto you that is above every other name. And at that name, every name was bowed. We declare you are the God of victory, that Jehovah, the Lord of hosts, the man of war. Father, we know we are called into battle, and we know we have fought our battle.
Amen.
Because you said clearly, be still and know that I am God.
Yes,
because we know from this moment, the packaging of the testimonies for us, they are beginning to be unloosed.
Amen.
They are beginning to be
unwrapped.
And they begin to speak as for. Because we are kept by the blood of the Lord and by the word of our testimony.
Amen.
The battle is not our own, Lord. It is your battle.
Yes,
we know that your servant was serving you, Lord.
Oh,
even Pastor Kenny, we know and we are rest assured.
Yes,
you have done it.
Yes.
You have done it.
Yes.
You are giving life instead of death.
Yes.
You are giving life instead of death.
Yes.
You know for serving the ministry.
Yes.
You have done it again.
Yes.
You have done it again.
Yes.
And for all them that are incest against us, your word said they shall fall for our sake.
Yes.
So when they shall spring up by grass, is it that they might be destroyed by you? Father, we thank you for the victory.
Amen.
Thank you for what this man has done today.
Amen.
Thank you for what Hurricane has done today.
Amen.
Thank you for what the Max has done today.
Amen.
Thank you for what the Israel has done today.
Amen.
We bless you, Father, because that is who you are. Because by your breath alone, you deliver your people in Israel. We know for sure does not take you anything to deliver.
Amen.
You are delivered. You are set free.
Amen.
And today we know you are beginning a new thing.
Amen.
You said we shall see it and it shall spring forth.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you praise. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you that your people are here. We love you. Worship you on behalf of every circumstance and situation of your life. We know that you are giving us victory. Bless up in the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed.
Amen.